the invariant of the loop and prove a simple theorem about it. The set of all nodes is partitioned into three sets: a settled set, a frontier set, and a far-off set. The invariant consists of three points. 1. For a settled node S, at least one shortest path from V to S contains only settled nodes, and d sub s is the distance of that shortest path from V to S. Think of the settled set as the places that we know all about because we have visited often and settled there. A node in the frontier has been visited at least once, but not enough to know for a certain that its shortest path distance has been fully calculated. Think of the frontier as the moon and close planets that we know something about, but not everything. We haven't settled there yet. Here's the second part of the invariant. 2. For a node F in the frontier, at least one path from V to F contains only settled nodes, except for the last one, F. And d sub f is the minimum distance over all such paths. That is, over paths that start with a settled node V, perhaps contain more red nodes, and finally have one edge to F. There is a degenerate case, when F and V are the same node, and it is in the frontier set. This degenerate case will make it easy to initialize the invariant, including putting V into the frontier set and not the settled set. Here's the third part of the invariant. 3. All edges leaving the settled set end in the frontier set. That's all there is to the invariant. Three simple and easy to remember points. Stop the video at this point and convince yourself that if F is in either the settled or the frontier set, the invariant implies that d sub v is zero. We now prove an important theorem. For a node F in the frontier set with minimum d value over nodes in the frontier, d sub f is indeed the shortest path from v to F. For example, suppose the frontier set contains three nodes, F0, F1, and F2, with shortest distances d sub f0 is 5, d sub f1 is 4, and d sub f2 is 6. Then F1 is the node in the frontier set with minimum d value. We prove this theorem by showing that any other path from V to F does not have a smaller distance. We consider two cases. Case 1, V and F are the same, and that node is in the frontier set. First, the settled set is empty, for, by invariant P1, if a node S is in the settled set, then V must be there too. But it isn't. It is in the frontier set. Second, since V is in the frontier set, by P2, the frontier set contains only one node, V. Third, we know that d sub v is 0, and 0 is the distance of the shortest path from v to v. Case 2. V is in the settled set. Suppose that the shown path from v to f is the one with distance d sub f. By part 2 of the invariant, d sub f is the shortest path distance over paths that contain only settled nodes, except for f. Consider any other path from V to F. It starts at V, goes through settled nodes, and visits F or another frontier node, G. If it visits F, then we know that the path distance is at least d sub f, and that case is taken care of. Suppose it visits another frontier node, G. Then it winds its way to F. Since d sub g is at least d sub f, and since edge weights are positive, the distance of this path is at least d sub f. QED, which stands for quit, end, done.